alone, there are 119,000 people waiting for an organ transplant to save their lives. Every time the phone rings, they wonder, is it the call that will give them a chance? All too often, though, that call, it just never comes. There aren't enough organs. One mom who knows that heartbreak firsthand has an idea on how to potentially solve the organ shortage. She has some support, though you might think it's a bit radical.
I wanted to see you high five them, and I wanted to send stuff like smile.
He was actually on the transplant list for 18 months. He was placed on the list when he was 10 years old, and we waited 18 months for a call to come.
It came 2 days after Thanksgiving in 2008. Jonathan Waldron, who'd spent his whole life battling cystic fibrosis, got a double lung transplant. It changed everything.
He played. He played football with his uncle. He played games with his brother. He went out and played in the dirt and in the woods.
He went to school. He lived the life for 5 years until his body attacked his new organs.
Unfortunately, he developed rapid rejection of his lungs over this past year, and his lung function dropped dramatically.
In February, Jonathan went back on the transplant list. He ended up at Boston Children's Hospital waiting for a second set of lungs.
There's not enough organ donors. There's not enough people signing up.
Jonathan's mom is urging you to at least consider it, and the state of New York agrees with her. Last month, a new law took effect that changed the DMV forms. Now, when you renew your license, you must say whether or not you want to be an organ donor. You can choose to skip the question, but you must check a box.
It's a great start. It really is, because at least it makes people look at it and think.
Marlene Waldron says the real solution is more radical. What they're already doing in countries including Spain, Austria, Belgium, and Singapore. She wants an opt-out system. You're an organ donor unless you specifically say you won't be one.
Well, it's certainly a great way of increasing your organ pool.
But Jonathan's doctor sees some potential problems with it, too.
I think it would be considered infringement on independence and on free will, necessarily, so I don't see that easily happening around here.
Jonathan's wait for a second transplant did not go well. The phone never rang. Doctors tried a life support system called ECMO, two hoses placed in John's neck doing the job of his lungs.
Can you take one step towards me?
But it wasn't enough.
He had me there, and he had his aunt, and we held his hand until he left us. And I hope he knew that.
Even with their loss, Jonathan's mom is forever grateful to his first donor family.
Yeah, I still thank them, even though Jonathan's gone, because I had those 4 years, 5 years that I wouldn't have had.
Jonathan died in September. Now, he did enjoy the kindness of strangers in his last days. He was a big gamer and loved Grand Theft Auto. But he wouldn't be alive when version 5 hit the market. So the people at Rockstar Games brought it to his hospital room in Boston, and they let him play it weeks before it hit the shelves.
At the risk of sounding morbid, how did they know he was going to die?
No, actually, it's a really good question, because John had developed a kind of cancer that's very common for transplant patients and usually very easy to treat. The cancer, though, meant that he was off the list for at least a year. Without new lungs, he would not live more than a few months. So he was in this horrible catch-22 position.
Okay, so this opt-out proposal that his mother wants, has this ever been considered in the States before?
You know what? It's been considered in New York before. Just a few years ago, it was introduced by a lawmaker whose child had a transplant. It didn't go anywhere. And as you saw in the story, that's not part of the state's new law.